ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا It is absolutely important that we start in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying Alhamdulillah. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. My brothers and sisters, I have one request from you. And that request is silence. We don't need to use our mouths, we just need to use our ears, inshallah. And at the same time, every one of us is struggling with this heat. I have decided to change my topic and my message to you to make it short and to the point. So, what I want to tell you is, many times people make a mistake when it comes to people like myself. It is not me who you should glorify. It is not me who can take you to paradise. It is not me who can help you in your grave. It is not me who is able to bring you good fortune. It is not me who you should be celebrating, but rather it is the message that you should be celebrating than the man who is standing in front of you. It is my duty that I say this. I am not a celebrity or a pop star. I am not someone who came to you with worldly materialistic items. I am your brother in faith and in humanity. I am a person who has come to you with a message of peace and goodness. I want you to be able to live with one another in peace and in harmony. And this is the teaching of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the teaching of the Maker himself. And it has come to us through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And through all the messengers who have been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the same message. The difficulty we are facing today is that we, whenever we have a problem amongst ourselves, we resort to means that create two problems out of one or 10 problems out of one. Rather than that, my brothers and sisters, learn to communicate with one another. Learn to talk to one another. No problem has been resolved through killing. No problem has been resolved through fighting. No problem has been resolved through expressing hatred, but rather through communicating, understanding, through achieving justice. This is what the message holds. And this is something that will resonate throughout the globe. We will be able to understand the value of one another when we think of what our value is in the eyes of others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. As I entered this beautiful hall, I realized very quickly two things. Many things, but from amongst them two, very quickly. Number one is the heat. You realize that? So it's my duty to cut down the size of my talk. I'm sure you will forgive me for that. Number two is, the excitement was actually embarrassing for myself. I will be honest with you. The excitement, I appreciate it. I understand it. But it's embarrassing to myself. The reason is, the message of peace comes with silence. It comes with goodness. Like I said, wallahi, there are people who are so keen on taking a selfie or a photo with me. If it were possible, perhaps it may have happened. But remember one thing, that selfie will not help you to enter Jannah. That selfie will not help you in your grave. That will not help you in any way. It is the message. Even if someone else delivers it and not me, for as long as that message is a pure, good message, that is what will help you. Not the man. If I did not come to you in person, it was not really going to have an effect on whether or not you are going to paradise. But rather, if you were impacted by a good message that came from Allah and His Messenger, from your Maker, a message that taught you how to live in the world in a way that you will earn paradise as well. You get goodness in this world and the next. That is the message that would actually result in your entry to paradise if you were to follow it. This is why Allah says, regarding Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom we are not even a comparison to, a person like myself, we are far, far, far away from the status of the messengers and his companions or their companions. But Allah says, قُلْ إِن كُنتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ. Say, if you love Allah, then follow me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you love Allah, follow the messenger. Follow the message that that messenger has brought. And Allah will love you in return and He will forgive your sins. So I come to you with the same message. If you love Allah, rather than glorifying a scholar who comes to you, a person who comes to you, rather than getting so excited about that particular person, you must get excited about the message. You must get excited about the message. Ask yourself, how close am I to my Maker? How is my character with the rest of those who were made by the same Maker? You understood what I said? The rest of those who were made by the same Maker, just like I have the right to live, all those whom that Maker has made have also the same right to live. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. May Allah grant us a deep understanding. My brothers and sisters, I am here in order to talk to you this evening about goodness, about living together in harmony, in peace, about promoting tolerance and goodness in your nation as well as in other nations. We want to promote this goodness, inshallah. The respect of one another. The respect of one another is the message we have. It is the message that we were taught from the beginning right up to this day. Take a look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life. Take a look at how compassionate he was. Take a look at the compassion that we were taught towards not only human beings, but even the other creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, when we have a problem with someone, we think violence will solve the problem. Killing will solve the problem. Fighting will solve the problem. That's not going to solve anything. That will create a bigger disaster. It will create a bigger problem. You have a problem with someone, learn to talk about it. Learn to understand. Learn to speak. Learn to try and keep on trying. If it takes me 10 years to solve a problem, wallahi, wallahi, my brothers and sisters, that 10 years is far more beneficial than me having killed a single person in the process. Remember that. If it takes me 10 years to solve a problem, that 10 years is worth it. Rather than to create a fitna and to create disaster, fighting and killing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us an understanding. I call on you all to learn, to educate yourselves, to understand what is the message of your Maker, to understand the balanced teachings of this beautiful faith of Islam, to understand that Islam comes to you, yes, with goodness. Every religion believes that they are right. Everyone believes they are right. If you speak to a Christian, he will tell you, we are right, you are wrong. Well, according to him, he will be judged by Allah. according to us, he will also be judged by Allah. That is why we are on earth. So if you speak to a Jewish person, he will say, we are right, you are wrong. Let him say that. But if you speak to us, we will also say, we believe we are right. So we are also allowed and entitled to say the same thing from a human perspective. Yes, indeed. From a religious perspective, everyone believes they are correct. If we are going to start fighting and killing based on those grounds, when are we going to be able to spread the goodness? I promise you, all of us seated here, all of us without exception, at some stage, some of our forefathers, somewhere down the line, were not Muslim. Do you know that? They were not Muslim. Someone loved us enough not to kill them. Do you understand? Someone loved us enough not to harm them. Someone loved us enough to talk to our forefathers somehow in a beautiful way so that they were convinced that that's the way of life I want to be in. That's when we became Muslim as a result. Some of us seated here, we might have entered the fold of Islam in our lives while our forefathers are not Muslim, or even our parents. What does Islam say? I want to just say one or two verses for you. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ Allah says He has instructed you, a good instruction regarding your parents. In one place He says حُسْنَا, in another place He says إِحْسَانَا. He says to do good to your parents. And this is speaking about parents who are not Muslim as well as those who are Muslim. What is the evidence? The evidence is the next part of the verse in Surah Luqman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا If they are trying hard to make you do that which is wrong according to Allah, if your parents are trying hard to remove you from Islam, if your parents are trying hard to make you associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that particular case Allah says you don't obey that one instruction that is against what Allah has taught, but you continue to respect them, you continue to be kind with them, and you live with them in a beautiful, good way. Allahu Akbar. Look at that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that these parents of yours who are not Muslim, you need to be kind to them, you need to serve them, but when they instruct you to do something against Allah's instruction, that is the only instruction you excuse yourself from respectfully. But Allah says you continue living with them with kindness. I hope we understand this, my brothers and sisters. This is regarding your relationship with non-Muslims. This is regarding your relationship with those who preach to you about another faith. It's talking about your parents. Allah is saying, when your parents are preaching to you regarding another faith, and they are telling you to quit your faith, the only thing you do is you don't quit your faith. You continue deeper and you show them that you are honorable. You show them your character, your conduct. You are still kind to them. How? Why would Allah say that? And Allah has said it more than once in the Quran. Why would He say that? Did Allah say, when you are a Muslim, stop talking to those who are not Muslim? Stop. If you stop talking to them, how are you going to spread Islam? That's the question I have. If your character is not good, how are you going to spread the goodness? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. My brothers and sisters, it is important that you realize that the message of Islam is a balanced message. Very balanced. I'm sure those who are born Muslim and those who know 15 to 20 years back, we did not have a lot of the problems that we are facing today on a global level. And the reason is, people, for some agenda of theirs, have hijacked the Muslims who are not educated enough in Islam to perpetrate crimes that Islam does not teach, with them thinking that it's part of Islam, and it is not. Remember this. It is my duty that I deliver this message to you. And I let you know, my brothers and sisters, I am a very, very mortal person. I am a human being. Perhaps I may not even be living tomorrow. Maybe tonight I may not be in existence again. It's possible, but the message will never die. Remember that. The message of goodness will never die. Remember that. You will carry that message, and we will all carry the message of goodness and peace. My brothers and sisters, like I said, as you can see, I'm sweating. and I've decided not to have a fan facing me anymore, and I've decided not to wipe my face. Do you want to know why? I want to taste what you who are sitting, those who are sitting in the crowd, feel. So that I know when to walk away. When everything here is totally drenched, I can walk away saying, look, they have endured and I have felt what they endured. For me to have a fan and an air condition, what's the point when everyone else is struggling? So I don't want to prolong my message. I have spoken for 14 minutes. And what I want to tell you, my brothers and sisters, I will not go beyond the 15th minute, inshallah. I know people came from far and wide to listen. The message has always been there. Like I said, whether it is delivered by me or by someone else, I want you rather to pray for one another. Instead of thinking that a rock star or a celebrity has come to you, which is actually, as I said, embarrassing and it is wrong, you rather pray for one another. May Allah bless you all. May Allah grant you goodness. May Allah protect your families. Learn to work hard within your families to develop a good relationship with your spouse, with your children. Learn to work hard in your communities to serve the communities in a way that they will see the goodness of Islam. Be kind to one another. Wallahi, I tell you, we have a lot to show. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was in our midst, what do you think he would have done? If he was in our midst, what do you think he would have done? He would have reached out to people. He would have helped as much as he can, as much as he could. I tell you, our hands, our eyes, our ability, our capacity, it will not last forever. It is a few years. In those few years, use it in the right direction. Make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with you. Before you leave, you need to realize and understand, before you leave this world, you need to prepare for the next. How you prepare for the next is, while you are in this world, you worship Allah alone and you are kind to the rest of His creatures. There is something known as Hukukullahi and Hukukul Ibadi. The rights of Allah, you will worship Him. You make sure you don't miss what is an obligation unto you. And the rights of the rest of humanity, the rest of the worshippers of Allah, those are even something absolutely important that we should never ever let go of. Understand, my brothers and sisters, that it is only through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will be able to achieve goodness. It is only through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will be able to achieve paradise. I ask Allah to bless you all with Jannatul Firdaus. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you all in a way that you can live in harmony and peace. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to solve whatever problems you may have in your lives in the most beautiful way. And may Allah grant cure to those who are sick and ill. May Allah grant rahmah to those who have passed away. May He be merciful upon those who are gone. And when we go, may the Maker Most High have mercy upon us as we leave this world. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.